Hi there, my name is Alexa. I want to tell you a story about how in life, there are situations when you dig yourself a hole and get into it yourself. This law almost always works. Have you noticed? My story is a great example of this, and now you will understand everything yourself. Stay with me, watch the story till the end, do not forget to like the video, write comments, and subscribe to our channel. My mother always loved tennis. She played it herself until she got an arm injury. And when I was born, she immediately said that she would have me play tennis. So I did. I played from a young age. First, she taught me at home, and then she handed me over to the professionals. My mother was proud of my achievements, and I think I tried really hard. I've had more tennis rackets than you can imagine over the years. They often tore or bent because of my long and frequent training. I didn't try only for the sake of my mother. I myself liked this sport, if only because it is beautiful. Don't you agree? Isn't it wonderful to watch the girls in their white uniforms hitting the ball and passing to each other? I think it's cool. At school, I was popular because I often played on behalf of the school and brought us a lot of victories. The principal and teachers often turned a blind eye to my absences due to training, and this sometimes infuriated my classmates. Gwen was the most infuriated. She also played tennis, but she had fewer wins than me. She always said that if she were in my place, she could bring a lot more victories than I did. Then I told her to be bold. There were 6 months left until the next competition, so there is time to prepare. She gave me a look of complete disdain and said that she would definitely beat me. Her infusion only encouraged me. I began to train even more persistently, because now I had not just an opponent, but an opponent full of hatred and envy towards me. All I could do was win it, and there was a lot of work to do. At school, I tried not to have much contact with her, but just a week later, I began to notice terrible things. I found some notes in my personal locker at school. They all appeared one by one. They were death threats. At first, I thought it was Gwen, but we had made a promise that we wouldn't talk at all for the next 6 months. And she didn't even look in my direction. After another 5 days, someone planted rotten eggs right under the porch of our house. I didn't want to tell my parents so as not to frighten them. They thought they were local hooligans. Every time, these tricks became more cruel and insidious. And when I found a photo in my locker where my eyes and mouth were drawn on my image, I was really nervous. It lasted for several months. My training was not as good as before because I was always thinking about those threats. I stood in confusion, looking at the photo and couldn't move. And then suddenly, a girl from my class came up behind me. Her name was Nina. She saw the photo, but I quickly hid it. "Ah, now they've got you too?" she said. I asked her what it meant, and she told me that the same thing had been done to her last year. I don't know why I deserved it, but until I went through all the circles of hell, the bullying did not stop. I didn't find the person who did it, and I didn't really want to look for them. Somehow, I was able to survive. "Apparently, you did something to annoy these people, and who knows what they have in mind," she said. So, she suggested that I have a little fun, so as not to think so much about the bad things. When it happened to me, I rested and positive emotions saved me. "Come to my house this evening. It will be fun," she said. At first, I refused, because it was the evening before the competition. I wanted to get a good night's sleep. But Nina was eloquent and convincing. I agreed. When I got to her house, I saw Gwen, and we were a little tense at first. I asked what she was doing there, to which Nina replied that she had invited all the girls, so that we could all just relax and have fun. I tried not to think about it, or think about how stressful my life had been in the last few months. We danced, we talked, they offered me drinks, but I refused. I didn't want to be in bad shape the next day. And then Gwen came up to me and said she was worried about tomorrow. "Oh my God, are you drunk?" I asked her. She was. Gwen suddenly began to cry, saying that she had been envious of me from the very beginning, that she was so far behind me, and that she was sure that tomorrow she would lose, but it would be an honor for her to fight with me on the same field. It was nice to hear that, and I hugged her and told her it was mutual. Gwen handed me a drink, but I declined, and she said it was in honor of our reconciliation. "I want to be friends with you and be a worthy opponent. What do you say? You need to drink to that. Just one glass, she said. I picked it up and we clinked glasses, and she told me to drink it all down. But as soon as I brought the drink to my nose, I sensed a strange smell, and then I saw some powder at the bottom of the glass that hadn't completely dissolved. At this moment, other girls were passing by. They were dancing and pushing. Gwen almost fell, and I grabbed her glass and quickly swapped mine for hers. She didn't notice because she was so drunk, so I drank her beer in front of her, and she drank mine. She stared at me for a long time and then suddenly fell unconscious. Everyone was scared, but she just fell asleep. The next day, I came to the competition. Gwen didn't look well, and she was very ill. It was so bad that she even walked unevenly. We started the competition, and I won in no time. After this quick victory, Gwen came up to me, and I held out my hand to her. But she was so angry. She said she hated me. The sweet Gwen from the night before had somehow disappeared. You should have lost! Stop it! She yelled. Why? Because you put stuff in my glass? Now I know you're the one who's been bullying me all these months. You're just afraid of me, I told her. She was surprised that I knew, and I said she couldn't get me drunk, so she dug a hole for herself. And I did everything right.
Hello to all from me. I'm Irina Mix, and I'm the most popular girl in our city. I know, it can be very cool, but no one thinks about the fact that it is, first, a huge work on yourself and on your image, and secondly, it is a constant pressure on you as a person. After all, everyone wants to know what you breathe, what you eat, and who you walk with. When you are popular, there is nothing that you can hide from your audience or fans. But I still decided to share with you a secret that no one knows about. Get ready, and more conveniently, listen and watch. To be honest, my popularity came to me unexpectedly. When I started a page on Instagram, I planned to use it as a normal user. But then it happened that all the plans changed dramatically, and I only had to meet one person. Yes, I have a boyfriend. His name is Austin. I don't think some of you know, but this is the mayor's son. Austin is a handsome and insanely rich guy, but there is one drawback with him. He is fickle. Well, from the beginning, we started dating almost immediately after my mother was elected to the post of head of our city. They had a very active race, and all their efforts were not in vain. Austin and I used to know each other, and he and I were childhood friends. All the girls from our yard wanted to win his heart, and with it, the status of his girl. I was one of them, but then he moved to another area, where there were mansions. He changed schools and homes, and we hadn't seen each other since, except to watch him on TV. But life is an interesting thing, and it so happened that we went to driving school together, where we met for the second time, because he forgot me. However, I also had changed very much. I was no longer the pimply, full teenager with braces. Over the years, I stretched out, became a slender blonde, and by nature, Austin was really interested in me, which was nice. I pretended not to know who he was, so I managed to catch his attention even more. However, later, on the third date, I still told him the truth, and it was a laugh. I realized that Austin had managed to retain his former charm, and I fell in love with him again, only with different eyes. In general, we began to meet, and moreover, we were almost immediately declared the most beautiful couple in the city. Yes, without exaggeration. We still specifically walked the streets often so that the press would take pictures of us from around the corner. And the next day, we looked at the pictures in the press, then on the internet, then on TV. Austin specifically did not give any comments about me, and this inflamed the intrigue. The network bombarded him with questions about the name of the companion. That is, me. Well, I didn't say anything either. It was just fun to watch my moment of fame. Austin knew how to choose the right moment, and our secret was revealed to the press a couple of months after we started dating. It was sensational. Our couple passed competitions in absentia for the title of the brightest, most harmonious couple in the city, which had a positive effect on the image of the mayor's son. I think it was more political, but his mom started inviting me to her house for dinner. All this was also mentioned in the press. That's how, slowly, I began to gain a frenzied popularity. My social networks exploded from messages, among which were also threats from haters. Someone promised to pour boiling water on me, acid, and someone offered to marry him. I tried not to take everything seriously. I learned to cope with the audience. I took up content to attract even more attention. Over time, I even had business offers, and I began to earn good money through the internet. In short, everything was fine. And as I mentioned, Austin is a good person, but fickle. A couple of months later, I found out about his infidelity, and it happened in the same way as I expected. Through the network, Austin went on some kind of date with a sequel. You know, I probably prepared myself mentally for this, so I won't say that I was very upset, although, yes, it was terribly painful and unpleasant to find out about it. I talked to him that night, and I only asked him not to tell anyone about it yet, especially the press. I had some plans for my career, and our breakup could have a negative impact on my image. As it turned out, he told his mother about everything, and she told him the same thing, so that he would not make our separation public yet, because she was also working on some project regarding her son, so any negative information could ruin everything. Especially in our situation, where her son turned out to be even more macho, this is the agreement we still adhere to. Yes, it's hard to believe, but once, we turned romantic feelings into politics. What? Do you think it's mean? No, we just did exactly what many popular couples do. In general, this went on for a while. We continued to meet, go on dates, and did it specifically in large crowds of people, so that there were as many witnesses as possible. A month later, I had already made a great deal with several major advertisers and received a good amount of money. Every time I had to pretend to be happy for Austin, or every time we made out in public for cameras that didn't seem to notice, it still hurt. Once I got him to talk to me, invited him to my house so we could have a quiet chat. Austin was surprised by the meeting of this format, having got used to the fact that our relationship became exclusively business. I just wanted to finally just talk about us. Austin thanked me for our relationship and the image we created together. In the end, both were still in the black. This situation has forced Austin to grow insolent to the end. He openly went left and right, trampled and muddied my name. He managed to cheat on me with a girl with whom we competed all our lives in clothes, hair, and everything. And when I told him all about it, Austin just told me to keep quiet because we were just partners. This offended me because it does not give him the right to humiliate me in front of everyone. After another 3 months, I suddenly realized that I didn't want to play like this anymore. I met a friend at a bar, got a little drunk, and started crying. I was whining so much that people couldn't help but notice, and I think the press was there too. I yelled at the whole bar that I was unhappy, that my boyfriend had betrayed me, and that I didn't want to see him again. The very next day, there were headlines on the covers of magazines with our pictures. Inside were my pictures, where I sat in a not very neat look with smeared makeup. Of course, Austin came running like a deer. He was angry, grabbed my hands, and started demanding an explanation. I had signed a contract, and his mother also had a fit of rage. They brought me to their house, and Mrs. Mayer gave me a questioning. They tried to pin me down, promised to squeeze all the lost money out of me and make me pay for the damage, but I learned something in a few months. I managed to fight them back. What? Compensation? With all due respect, Mayor, I'm not going to pay you anything, and I can even demand the same from you, because it's not my son who leads a wild life. I know every girl in the city that he's been dancing with, who he's been drinking with, and how. I know his joints from when you first took office, and I have a video of your son's very important, inappropriate statement about what he's going to do now that his mom is mayor. So let's not hurt my feelings. I gave out. This was a surprise not only for them, but also for me. Yes, I didn't expect it myself, to be honest. And then I set my conditions. I said that my separation from Austin will happen on my initiative. I will write about it on my page and he will not comment on anything. Nothing at all. Plus, all the money raised from my name, they will return to me. This will be discussed separately by my pre-hired lawyer. The mayor wasn't happy, but she couldn't help it because they were afraid of me and I was elated. In general, in our war, I won. And after parting, I have subscribers and fame even more. So girls, you need to think with your head. Also, don't let anyone offend you. Not even the mayor. By the way, do not forget to put likes, comment on my story, write your opinion, and be sure to subscribe to the channel.